My name's Thomas. I am the brand manager here at House Roots Coffee in Granada Hills. We've been open since September, and my role here is to make sure everything's looking somewhat okay. My role is making sure the customer's experience is as best as we can have it, from menus to furniture, social media. It's kind of my role here. House Roots Coffee was started by a bunch of Valley kids. You know, we're in the San Fernando Valley right now, and we all grew up together. We went to church together. We would drive down to downtown to check out the cool stuff together, and then come back. And you know, growing up, there wasn't a lot of good. The Valley didn't have a very good reputation past the 80s. I think the 80s, the Valley was great. You know, Karate Kid, Sandlot, all these things were getting shot here.
Valley Girl.
Yeah, the Valley Girls. But like kind of late 90s and early 2000s, like people didn't really have many good things to say about the Valley. We really wanted to open something like a cafe or a music venue that would bring life back to the Valley. Like, hey, the Valley's cooler than I thought. Like we would love it when people would talk about the Valley in this way, in a positive way. So around like 2010, end of 2010, early 2011, we started to learn coffee. And we didn't have anywhere to do it, so we just started practicing at our church. We would make pour overs, buy V60s off of Amazon, buy beans from Starbucks, and eventually we got like a tiny espresso machine, and that's just kind of how it started. And we started to form a community, which was really cool. People started to come and want coffee, and a couple of us realized very quickly that we didn't know what we were doing. We had no idea what we were doing in terms of coffee. We called it like YouTube education, so whatever we found on YouTube, that's how we were learning how to make coffee. And then we reached out to James from Cafe Dulce. Hey, James. And we basically asked him to take us under his wing. Our first guy, our coffee director, his name is Jimmy. He got a job there, then eventually I got a job there, which was tough, because at that time, Dulce was one of the very few coffee shops. Us being at Dulce was so we could learn the craft of coffee, learn the art of hospitality, because I think to this day, Dulce is one of the most comfortable, hospitable coffee shops you can find yourself in. So we wanted to really take that and implant it back into the Valley. So that's why we chose the Valley. We hated people talking bad about our city. We knew we weren't going anywhere anytime soon. So for about 2.5 years, we drove down every morning to pull shifts at Cafe Dulce, learn coffee, and eventually started raising money ourselves and started doing pop-ups. We built little carts, did wedding venues, did farmers markets, popped up for about 3.5 years in like Santa Clarita, in the San Fernando Valley, by Magic Mountain. You know, we popped up and we started to gain traction and gain a following. And that's what kind of platformed us to be in this space now back in the Valley. So a little long-winded way to answer your question, but yeah, we always knew we wanted to be in the Valley. We always told each other, like, you know, the downtown LA is really cool, but they got enough cool stuff. It's time that the Valley has some goodness coming out of it, you know?
Wow. Yeah.